In this video, I will be showing how you can add titles and text animation to your video using a free online video editing tool called Kapwing. Hey guys, my name is Hafiz and welcome to Roll Record, where I help beginners get started with making videos. On this channel, I share tips and tools to help you go faster and further in your video making journey. So if that is something that you are into, please consider subscribing. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is to open your favorite internet browser and go to kapwing.com. You can do this on your desktop computer, your phone, whichever you prefer. Also, there is no need for you to download and install anything on your device because everything will be done through the website and Kapwing does all the heavy lifting for you. Register yourself for a free account and once you've done that, go ahead and log in and you will be greeted by a page that looks like this. This is your Kapwing account homepage. Click on New Content and you are presented with a few options. You can start with a blank canvas, which means you can create something from scratch, or you can choose any of the methods here to upload your video. Click and directly upload from your device, or you can drag and drop the file. If you have a link to the video, like a YouTube link, you can copy and then paste the link in this text box. You can also do it from your Google Drive or Google Photos account. And lastly, if you just want to mess around and explore Kapwing, you can try a sample clip by clicking here. In this instance, I will be dragging and dropping my file. Give it a couple of seconds and your video will be added to what Kapwing calls the studio mode. Anyway guys, I have done quite a few tutorials on Kapwing, so if you are interested, you can check out the link to a playlist that I have right in the description box down below. Okay, just to give you a quick orientation, this area here is the canvas that shows you a preview of the video you uploaded. This area here is the timeline, which we will be using a lot. Okay, so what I have here is a short video of me taking apart the lens of a camera. And just scrubbing through quickly, you can see that it's an instructional, step-by-step style kind of video. Now, what I feel the video is lacking is text information, and I think it will be very helpful to the viewer if I included text with a little bit of animation. In addition, I will also be adding a title at the beginning and at the end of the video just to complete the overall look and feel. Now, let's start by adding a title at the start of the video. On the left-hand side, you can see a set of icons. Go ahead and click on the icon that says text. A list of options will appear and it's up to you which one you prefer. I will be going for this one. From here, I will change the text to how to remove the top part of a lens. Now, if we shift our attention to the right, you have more options to play around with. Let's take a quick look. Like many text editors, we have the ability to change the font. Kapwing allows you to do a search, so if I try looking for Oswald, it's there. You can also change the size of the font, and there is a lock ratio button that if checked ensures that no matter how much you resize it, the format of the text will not change. For instance, this is what happens if I turn it off. Okay, I like how that looks. Moving on, we have the very familiar bold, italic, underline buttons, and left, middle and right align buttons. You can change the color of the text if you want, and also the outline. We have a choice of none, light and dark, but I'll go for light. Moving on, you have the option of having a background color for your text, which I will add. I'm also adding rounded corners to soften things up a little by sliding this bar. Now, I think it still needs a little bit more softening, so I am going to reduce the opacity to make it look slightly transparent so that it blends in with the video. Okay, that's better. If you want to, you can also adjust the line height. In this case, I am going to leave it as it is. Next, let's move to the text to the center using the red guidelines that appear automatically to help you get the text centered. Now that's looking perfect, so let's move on and animate the text. At the top and on the right, go ahead and click on the tab that says Animate. You have a few choices. Just to show a few, we have Fade, Reveal, Pop, and Slide. You also can choose the speed of the animation. Now, I prefer a slow speed for the animation as I feel anything other than that is too fast. Lastly, you can choose if you want the animation to appear only at the start, at the end, or both. I'll be choosing both. Alright, there is our title at the start. From here on, I'll be picking up the pace a little bit because the steps are similar. If there is a need for you to go back in case you missed something, please do so. So let's go ahead and add text and I will call it step 1. Add another text for description and I'll describe this as use a spudger tool to loosen the metal ring. I'll also be adding a similar light text outline and also add a background color. I'm going to go ahead and align the text to make sure it's centered for both. I think I'm going to change the top text to yellow just so it stands out a little bit more and also differentiates the two text boxes that we have. Next, let's now apply the animation for both, and in this instance, I am going for fade. Right now, I'm readjusting the duration of the text to appear longer on my video by dragging the ends. For both the animation speed, it is set to slow and will apply at the start and the end. Okay, step 1 done. Let's make 2 more sets. The fastest way to do it is to use the duplicate button. Let me show you. Select the text you want and press duplicate. Move it to the right part of the video and change the text as necessary. Do the same for description and click on duplicate and move them and change the description. Lastly, let's do an ending title to wrap up the video. Go to the title that we did at the start and press duplicate. Let's move it to the ending and let's change it to the end. Once you are happy with everything, you can now go ahead and click on export video. Give it a couple of minutes and there you have it. On the left, you have a preview player which allows you to view your edited video. On the right, to download, simply click on the download button here and it will save it to your device. If you want to make any changes, you may do so by clicking on edit. To watch another tutorial video like this one, check out this video right here. Thank you for watching and I'll catch you guys in the next one.